Good afternoon, Way fans. Van the Man McNeil, welcome to today's game. Thank you again, Way fans. Love you all. It's good to be back. Today's game between the Missouri Comets and your Milwaukee Wave. Before we get going here today, our friends at the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 494, here to present our winner for the most electrified player of the month. You want to say a few words? No, absolutely. This month, the Local 494 Electrified Player of the Month is Mr. Marcel Feenstra. How about a hand for Dutchie? Marcel couldn't be here. He's in game mode. He's starting tonight, coach, right?
That's correct.
So Mark Litton, goalkeeper coach for the past 10 years with your Milwaukee Wave, accepting the award on Marcel Feenstra's behalf. How about a nice round of applause? Your Local 494 Electrified Player of the Month, goalkeeper Marcel Feenstra. All right, before we get going here this afternoon, eyes up to the video board and a very special message from owner Sue Black. Sue?
See you.
Go get him, Tiger.
Yeah.
What a great day. I couldn't sleep last night. Have you ever been like you just want to get up in the morning? You're just so excited for the day to happen. Well, that's today. And thank you, everybody, for being here. I'm so excited. Been a great season. So proud of these guys. Let's bring home a win today. Go Wave.
Dear MKE is a love letter to the city of Milwaukee. It started as a series of short and brilliant documentaries, and then it grew into a chance for anyone who calls Milwaukee home to tell its stories. And who tells our stories better than us? Well, no one. Find the people, the places, the events that make this city so endearing. Write them up, take a picture, make a video, and then just upload it to DearMKE.com or use the hashtag DearMKE on Instagram or Twitter. I cannot wait to see your submission.
You got to look out for that Victor Kiros. He's a kissing fool, that Victor. Heads up, eyes up to the video board. Now we check in with head coach of your Milwaukee Wave, Keith Tozer. Coach?
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our house, the USL, for today's MISL action between the Missouri Comets and your Milwaukee Wave. The charity for today is the Urban Ecology Center, and the sponsor of today's match is our wonderful friends at Freighter Sports Medicine. Also, big shout-out goes to Reina International for being the official car provider of the Milwaukee Wave. Also, March 10th is Monday Night Football. That's our first playoff game here at 7 p.m., and tickets are on sale. Also, summer camps are right around the corner. Go to MilwaukeeWave.com to get more information. Well, it's time. Sit back and enjoy professional indoor soccer. We'll be right back.
from the U.S. Cellular Arena in downtown Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It's the Major Indoor Soccer League. Today, the Milwaukee Wave hosting the Missouri Comets. And a pleasant good afternoon, everyone. Tom Wynn, along with Wave Hall of Famer Art Kramer, here on the Badger Max pregame show as Wave gets set to take on the Missouri Comets in the regular season finale of the 2013-14 Major Indoor Soccer League season. Well, Art, Wave can clinch the number one spot, the regular season title, with a victory here today. They're 16-3, 8-1 on the home turf. The only team that beat them here, in fact, the only team that beat them anywhere this year, the Missouri Comets. Comets are 3-2 against the Milwaukee Wave this year, including a couple of wins down in Independence. If the Comets win today, they've already clinched third place. They would then play the number two-seeded Milwaukee Wave in the league semifinals. It would be the fourth consecutive year. So I guess both teams have to decide, can they get too much of one another in this rivalry?
Well, Missouri certainly can't get enough of the Milwaukee Wave because, as you said, they've beaten the Wave 3 out of 5 this year. And on the flip side, they have really struggled against the Baltimore Blast. They've lost their last 5 against the Blast. So for Coach Vladko Ananovsky, on the surface, it might not seem like a huge game. But I can tell you, this team wants to play the Wave in the semifinals. They are going to come out and try to replicate what they did last weekend, coming here and beating the Wave.
If Milwaukee is able to win, they would then go into a first-round matchup against the Syracuse Silver Knights. Baltimore, meanwhile, is also at 16-3. They are in Reading today to take on the Pennsylvania Roar. So you figure our Baltimore.
They're 17-3 then, huh?
Yes. So the Wave would clinch the tiebreaker by virtue of their two-game sweep over the Blast. But otherwise, I think we set the scenario pretty accurately here. Last time Missouri took on the Wave was a week ago here, Sunday. They came away with a 15-9 victory. What did you think were the keys for the Comets in that game?
Well, I thought it was more the Wave's undoing than what the Comets did. Although, take nothing away from the Comets. They played good staunch defense in front of Danny Waltman. Waltman had a very good game. But for the Wave, they're going to change up their tactics today. Last week, they high-pressured the Comets all over the field. Today, they're going to drop back into their own zone, absorb some pressure, look to counterattack, and Coach Tozer feels like that'll take the really high pace action out of play, make it a lower court game a little bit, and try to defend in front of Marcel Feenstra.
Top two scoring teams in the league offensively, but also two of the top three goalkeepers in Danny Waltman for the Comets and Marcel Feenstra for the Milwaukee Wave. Leo Gibson, the league's leading scorer, he all but has the scoring title wrapped up. Milwaukee's Ian Bennett, number two behind him. You look from the Wave's perspective, Art, they pull out a victory last night over St. Louis 16-12, had to rally back from a 10-4 second half deficit. Probably not the most resounding result that they were looking for going into the game. Nonetheless, a good comeback, a good victory, and they still keep the momentum going for this weekend.
Yeah, last night's gone. I don't think Coach Tozer is even concerned as soon as the game ended. Today's the day, and it's all on the line for the Wave here, the regular season title. You can't ask for anything more as a player to go in and have the opportunity to win a regular season championship on your own turf.
So it should be another great one today between these two rivals in the MISL. But before we get to the rest of today's game, let's take a look at some of the highlights from last night's contest.
All right, Dan. It was, to say the least, an interesting game last night as the St. Louis Ambush, a team already out of the playoffs, having lost 9 straight, but aren't they showed up to play last night?
Well, they got the early lead, and one of the keys today, Tom, is the Wave needs to come out sharp from the get-go, try to get Missouri playing from behind and make it difficult, because the last time these two teams played, Missouri sat back, they were able to dictate the tempo, and the Wave needs to get that going today.
See, Mike Roach's goal there actually put the Ambush up 8-2 early in the second period, but then the Wave would start its comeback just before the half. The Juan Salas Oliveira finding Marcelo Fontana, make it 8-4. However, Ambush immediately come out with a goal, 2-man advantage on the power play that was scored by Corey Dowell, who had 3 goals of the night. But there's a man who had 3 goals of the night for the Milwaukee Wave, Marcio Liete.
It really became the Marcio Liete show in the second half. 3 goals to really propel the Wave to victory over St. Louis yesterday. Wave's going to need another big game from number 77, Marcio Liete, here this afternoon.
You saw Victor Quitos put one in on the power play that made the score 10-8 at the time, and then Liete sneaking one net past the rookie goalkeeper Greg Crook, and that evened the game. But then Leite really making the play of the game.
Yeah, I like it. He did it on the power play, he did it from outside, and then he did it defensively as well, stripping the St. Louis defender, coming in and adding a big defensive pressure goal as well.
And Wave would get a very much needed
extra goal scored by Nick Pereira off a nice play from Quiros, and they would really need it too, because with just 25 seconds left, Corey Adamson headed one in to make it a two-point game. And then with St. Louis pressing up shorthanded, Wave comes in three against the keeper, Liette, setting up Ian Bennett. And the Wave's top scorer, second leading scorer in the league, puts it in. And Milwaukee takes a 16-12 victory. So, as we said at the outset, Art, maybe not the most resounding result that people in Wave Nation were looking for heading in the game, but a nice comeback and a good win for Milwaukee.
Yeah, that's the key. It was a win.
We'll be right back with more. This is Wave Soccer, the Major Indoor Soccer League.
Fans, thank you for coming today. Fan appreciation game, and we have a lot of prizes for you. But before any of that, let's get things started for today's game and meet the visiting Missouri Comets. Please welcome number three defender, Elaine Mattingu. Starting at forward, number five, Ramon Palmer. Number six forward, Max Toulouse. Starting at midfielder, number seven, Vahid Asadpour. Number eight, midfielder, Milan Ivinkovic. Number nine, forward, Stefan St. Louis. Starting at forward, number 14, Leo Gibson. Number 16, defender, Andre Braithwaite. Number 18, midfielder, Brian Perez. Number 19, midfielder, John Sosa. Starting at defender, number 20, Stefan Stokic. In goal for the Missouri Comets today, number 24, Danny Waltman. Starting at defender, number 25, Brian Harris. Number 32, midfielder, Lucas Rodriguez. And at number 77, forward, Alex Megson. Head coach of the Missouri Comets is Vladko Andonovsky. He's a defender from Milwaukee, number three, Philip Surprise. A defender from the Ivory Coast, number six, Judson McKinney. Starting at midfielder from Brazil, number seven, Luan Oliveira. A defender also from Brazil, number eight, Fabinho. A forward from Madrid, Spain, number 14, Nick Pereira. A defender from Milwaukee, number 15, Tony Wall. At midfielder, co-captain from Argentina, number 20, Marcelo Fontana. Starting at midfielder from British Columbia, number 21, Juliano Oliveira. Starting at midfielder from Mexico, number 23, Victor Quiros. Starting at forward from Canada, number 26, Ian Bennett. Starting at defender from South Africa, co-captain number 28, Jonathan Greenfield. At midfielder from Milwaukee, number 29, J.D. Banks. And at midfielder from Brazil, number 77, Marcio Leite. At midfielder from Brazil, number 79, Everton. On the bench in his 22nd season as head coach of the Milwaukee Wave, Keith Tozer. He's assisted by Juliano Oliveira. In his 10th season, goalkeeper coach, Mark Litton. Also on the bench, The Rock, the staple of the organization. In his 30th season, the original member of the Wave organization, athletic trainer Larry Sales. Tonight's Syndic's captain of the game is Will Frawley. How about some noise for your six-time champion, Milwaukee Wave! Today's Fradert and Medical College of Wisconsin scratch report, not playing in tonight's game, Nick Vorberg, Andy Hackbarth, Tenzin Rampa, J.C. Banks. Pre-game scratch report brought to you by Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin, where the finest minds in medicine have their minds on you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the singing of our national anthem, performed today by St. Gregory the Great Children's Choir. Presenting the colors for today's game are members of the UWM Army ROTC. St. Gregory the Great's Children's Choir and our national anthem. Today's flower giveaway brought to you by our friends at Welke's House of Roses. Alrighty, kicking out the first ball for today's contest. Joseph Bemis, Jakari Lopez, Aaron Dove, along with our Skywalk Pharmacy Hero of the Game representative, Mandy and Kira Granatella, and Bradley Gunette. When you're ready, one, two, 3, kick. How about a nice round of applause for our first ball participants? Kicking out, or rather bringing out the official Sendix game ball for today's game, Will Froling. Come on over, Will. Thank you, buddy. Put those hands together for our Sendix captain of the game. There he goes, running off the field with Brad Beach. That's Will Froling.
So we are just about set to go with the start of today's contest between the Missouri Comets and the Milwaukee Wave. Once again, Tom Wynn along with the Wave Hall of Famer Art Kramer greeting you from the U.S. Cellular Arena in downtown Milwaukee. There is the man in the nets for the Milwaukee Wave today, Marcel Veenstra, seventh-year veteran out of the Netherlands. Record of 13-2 with a 10.11 points against average. And a 741 save percentage, second in the league as far as PAA, third in save percentage. He's had a very solid year. And again, Art, he's had to basically man the pipes the entire second half of the season with the injury to Nick Borbert.
You mentioned it, Feenstra 13-2. His counterpart, Danny Waltman, in goal for Missouri, right there on the ball, 13-6. So the winner of this game will end up the regular season leader for wins in the MISL. It's either going to be Waltman or Feenstra.
Waltman third in the league in points against average at 10.63 and fourth in save percentage at 7.23. Comets in blue, they go left to right to start the action. Jonathan Greenfield taking it away from Ramon Palmer as Wave will move it up ahead. Ramon Palmer number 5, Robert Palmer number 12. Both former stars at Park University. Just outside the Kansas City area. Marcio Liete cracking one and a nice save by Waltman on the three-point blast.
Well, Waltman equal to the task on the first shot against him. See Jonathan Greenfield, number 28, back in the lineup for the Wave. He replaces Pablo on the back line from yesterday.
Greenfield, the veteran, South African native, just turned 33 recently. 32, I should say, for Jonathan. I don't mean to age him prematurely. Celebrated his birthday a couple of weeks ago. Waltman will roll that one out for Stefan Stokic.
Tom, you see the Wave dropping back all the way into their own half of the field. Both teams are going to employ this tactic defensively. It's going to be a real chess match here this afternoon between Coach Tozer and Coach Vladko Andonovsky.
Comets seemingly much different on the road as far as their defensive pressure. At home at the Independence Event Center, they normally are all over the Wave, all over the field. But as you said, playing laying back here, and Milwaukee doing likewise to start the game here. So each goalkeeper should have plenty of space to work with as far as distributing the ball downfield. Alex Megson, who has been a nice acquisition for the Missouri Comets. Megson, of course, son of Neil Megson, former star with the Tacoma Stars in the MISL, longtime pro out in Seattle-Tacoma area. Fabinho with it. Knocks it into the zone. It's broken up. Comets start back. Here's Stefan Saint-Louis trying to nudge it ahead for Megson. Broken up, but it comes back to Lucas Rodriguez. Rodriguez, who is having excellent season so far for the Comets. The fourth-year pro out of Mid-American Nazarene College.
Not only is he having an excellent season, he's been very tough against the Wave as well. I think twice he's had 7 points or more in a game.
He was the big star for them offensively last game with a couple of goals, including what proved to be the eventual game winner in that 15-9 victory. It's actually a 10-9 game, and then the Comets were able to strike for a couple of goals into the empty net as the Wave had gone to the extra attacker to try to get back in it. Here's Marcello Fontana coming upfield. Lays it off to Everton. Now Everton walking in. Shot! Save! Waltman! As Everton tried to go through the five hole, and Waltman covering up.
I believe Ivanovic might have gotten a piece of that as well in front of Danny Waltman, number 8 in blue for Missouri.
Waltman had an excellent game last time out against the Wave, and he is off to a good start so far here today. Actually, both keepers, I thought, played great in the last game. But Comets able to emerge victorious. As I said, they lead the season series 3-2 coming in. So they can actually beat the Wave in a season series for the first time ever. Phil Surprise drives one in far side. Top of the area. And the shot by J.C. Banks off the mark. Rebound, Oliviero. That one just wide. J.C. gets it back. J.C. did not play last night. The rookie out of Milwaukee. Of course, his father, a former star for the Wave back in the late 80s, early 90s. The legendary Jimmy Banks. Here's J.C. Shot. Kick save, Waltman. J.C. heads it back in the middle. And a header by Oliviero up and over. So a very active shift that time for J.C. Banks, the rookie out of UW-Green Bay.
Well, that shift started with Marcel Feenstra in the Wave goal, getting possession of the ball, and then coming up and throwing long. The Wave really transitioning quickly out of their own zone and trying to generate a quick counterattack against Missouri.
Livier, another guy who did not play last night. Giuliano at 40 years young, just celebrated his birthday last week. And again, player assistant coach, Keith Tozer trying to see if he can, don't want to say limit his minutes, but maybe appropriate them in the right fashion, make sure he's ready for the postseason.
We were talking before the game, and you mentioned how effective Oliviero has been against Missouri in the past, so another reason to get him in the lineup today.
Victor Quiros battling on the far side, taking away Leo Gibson. Tried to center on the play for Rodriguez. Had him there, but the pass was behind him. Gibson, the league's top scorer, coming in at 76 points. He's also the league's top playmaker at 25 assists. Taken away by LSO for the Wave, Luan Salas Oliveira, the 26-year-old Brazilian. Second season with the Wave. Nick Pereira tied up, poked away as Missouri putting on a little bit of upfield pressure that time. Quiros into the zone. Now finds Tony Walls. Tony turns and cracks one from three. Save is made. LSO had it. Lost it, got it back, but then taken away by the Comets. And now work to Megson on the near side. Wave Soccer is brought to you in parts by the Freighter and the Medical College of Wisconsin Sports Medicine Center, Guardian Credit Union, Lamer's Bus Lines, the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 494, Ian's Pizza, Milwaukee, Steinhoffel's Furniture, Southwest Airlines, and on Milwaukee.com. So again, we'd like to thank all of our many fine sponsors for being with us this year on the Wave broadcasts. And a reminder that today's game, again, brought to you by the Freighter and Medical College of Wisconsin Sports Medicine Center.
Tom, both these teams came into the game having scored 320 points on the season. You got the two highest scoring teams in the league. And if you tuned in looking to see a lot of goals or a shootout, you've really come to the wrong channel, because this is going to be a low scoring game. It's going to have a playoff feel. Safe to say the team that gets to 10 first may win this game. If you want to see goals, switch over to Baltimore and Pennsylvania.
Well, these are the 2-4 teams defensively in the league as far as points against, we mentioned, each with an outstanding goalkeeper. Wave has yielded 194 points, Missouri 213, so the Wave 19 less points, or about a point less per game defensively than the Comets. Three-point goals, Wave with 22, Missouri 14, and three-point goals allowed, the Wave has given up 16. They're a plus 6. Missouri 21, they're a minus 7. Both these goalkeepers have not really been airtight as far as yielding three-pointers, especially Waltman this year. So we may still see a three-pointer in this contest from somebody. Holding foul called by Shane Butler. Shane Butler, Mark Kidlicek, the officials as assigned by the Major Indoor Soccer League working today's match. No score about midway through the first period. As Comets will bring it up. Oliviero midfield for the Wave, drops it back to Fabinho. Now Giuliano in the corner, checked off the play by Brian Harris. Greenfield gets a foot on it, but the Comets come away with it. Trying to push up for a 3-on-4. And at midfield, Max Talut loses control. Comes back to Fabinho. Speaking about Talut, he's coming off a 5-goal game against the St. Louis Ambush in that 27-6 victory by the Comets at St. Louis Thursday night.
Safe to say, had he played a full season, I think you probably would be looking at the rookie of the year in the MISL.
31 points in just 8 games. He's already in the top 25 scoring, even though he's only played in 8 previous games, 3 of those with the Pennsylvania Roar. Oh, great look, far post. Phil Surprise stopped by Waltman off a great pass. I think it was McKenney who found him at the far post.
Surprise just wasn't able to get enough of his foot on that shot to get it past Waltman.
So great look there, but again, credit Waltman with an excellent save. And once again, Danny Waltman appears to have the hot hand starting off in the nets for the Missouri Comets. Bennett trying to come in from the line, and shot is blocked. Sosa comes out of there with it, broken up. Comets get it back to Lute at midfield. They're calling to Lute the Haitian sensation, native of Haiti. I'm trying to, begs a good question, Art. Who was the last notable Haitian that played in the MISL?
I would say Gerald Magic Celestian, who used to play for the New York Arrows, my former teammate with the Kansas City Comets. Magic was a tremendous Haitian player.
Yes, he was. Very skilled. There's a foul on the far side as Megson drills Oliveira against the wall.
Magic Celestin, like his namesake, Magic Johnson, used to get that no-look pass on those 3-on-2 and 2-on-1 opportunities. You see the foul there on Luan Oliveira.
Luan looks like he's okay. All right, free kick coming Greenfield. He'll rope one in there just a bit high. Good crack by Jonathan, just a little bit high above the frame. Comets clear. Greenfield gets it back. Crocs another one off the frame. Oh, Johnny Greenfield. A couple of nice strikes back to back, but unlucky.
Well, Greenfield not in action yesterday. It was a coach's decision, but it looks like Jono, number 28 for the Wave, has come to play here this afternoon. Good sign for the Wave.
Here comes Ivanovic to the near side. Tried to play it in, but scooped up by Feenstra. Remember, the Wave, if they win, will take on the Syracuse Silver Knights in the first round of the MISL playoffs, the semifinals. Game one would be in Syracuse on Friday night. Game two here Monday, March 10th at 7 p.m. If the Wave loses to the Comets, then they would play the Comets again in the playoffs Sunday afternoon in Missouri. That's a 3 o'clock start at the Independence Event Center, Sunday, March 9th. And then returning back here for that same Monday night, March 10th date, 7 o'clock. Monday Night Football, the Wave's first home playoff game. Call the Wave office, 414-224-WAVE, or you can order online at MilwaukeeWave.com. Let's send it down to Van McNeil.
Thank you, Tom. You see her every morning on Fox 6 Wake Up News and Real Milwaukee. Honored to have the lovely Nicole Coughlin in the house with us tonight. Nicole, where are you hanging?
Hey, Van. I'm glad to be here. Hey, Milwaukee. Thanks for having me. I'm out at the Steinhoffel's Relaxation Suite, and I just happened to meet Max. Hi, Max.
Hi.
Are you ready for some trivia?
Sure.
All right. No pressure. Here's the question. Who is currently leading the Wave with blocks? Is it Fabinho? Is it Jonathan Greenfield? Victor Quiroz or D, Judson McKinney? What do you think?
Is it C, Victor Gross.
It is. Nicely done, sir. You are taking home a Rocky Rococo's prize pack. Congratulations. Back to you, Van.
Thank you, Nicole. Nicole Coughlin from Fox 6 Wake Up and Real Milwaukee. Nicole here on her day off.
There you see Wave Keach-Kothoser, the winningest coach in the history of North American professional indoor soccer. Keach-Kothoser today looking for career victory number 747. And interesting, Art, how this restart position of the ball a little bit further out than where the foul appeared to be called.
Well, it was spotted by the referee, and then he moved it.
Wave able to step up and break up the initial restart there. Now Ian Bennett comes in, takes away from Gibson. Here's I Plush streaking downfield. Ian Bennett coming in. Shot save. Well, I thought Ian was going to take another touch.
Yes, he had
the defender.
He had Sosa beat. And as you said, Tom, he could have taken another touch and gotten closer to Waltman before he let that shot go.
Nonetheless, a great run upfield by Ian Bennett. Bennett, as we mentioned, the Waves' leading scorer, 64 points, second in the league behind Missouri's Leo Gibson, who leads with 76. So unless Ian has an absolutely monster game today and Gibson gets shut out, Gibson's going to win the scoring title. Speaking of Gibson, he takes it away, comes in, lays it off near side. Vahid Aspor trying to center, and what a save there by Feenstra. As he stopped, I think it was Brian Perez on the header at the far post. Harris, Aspor, now Gibson looking the back through. Aspor had a check as he was running through, no foul called. Meanwhile, Leite looking upfield, finds Nick Pereira. Nick, the third-year man out of Cal Santa Barbara, looking for man streaking to the post. I think it was J.C. Banks in tight. Couldn't get it on the goal. Now Fontana with a left-footer, and the save is made by Waltman.
Good work at the other end that time by Aspor, Gibson, and Brian Perez. Perez at the far post, and Feenstra with a great reaction save with his right hand to Rob Perez.
Aspor, by the way, coming back in the lineup after missing the last four games. He's still sixth in the league in scoring to 55 points, as we talked about, Art, probably on his way to an MVP season until he got hurt.
Yeah, he probably would have challenged Gibson for that scoring title. He was ahead of Gibson when he went down.
Comets control. They go left to right in the blue uniforms as you look at the screen. Now Rodriguez with it. Rodriguez, originally born in Argentina, moved to the U.S. in the Lenexa, Kansas area when he was 11 years old. Stokic will play it back. Waltman. Danny sporting those bright yellow gloves today. In it comes. Oh, unlucky ball that squirted off the back heel of one of the Wave defenders and put away by the Comets, and they take the lead 2-0.
You just can't give an inch inside your own penalty area. That's going to be a big key to who wins this game, is who can win the battle in their own penalty areas. And that time, the Comets win the battle. Watch again here. The play starts with Braithwaite, who lays a ball into the corner. And right there, it was actually
J.C. Banks
who flicked it in front of his own goal. The ball's got to go out along the boards and wide.
So Lucas Rodriguez scores what should be an unassisted goal. And there's that man again, Rodriguez, who is just eating the Wave alive this year. 2-0 Comets. Missouri looking to finish 14-6. They are 6-3 on the road. And again, looking to beat the Wave for the first time ever in a regular season series. This is the 20th regular season match between the clubs in the 4 years they've been battling. Wave leads the series 11-8, 5-4 here at the U.S. Cellular Arena. Wave beat the Comets 3 out of 4 in the first year. That was 2010-11. 4 out of 6 the next year. The team split 4 games last year. And as we said, the Comets lead 3-2 in the series this year. Final day of regular season competition in the MISL this season. A little bit later on, you will have Baltimore playing at Reading against the Pennsylvania Roar, and Syracuse hosting Rochester to wrap up the campaign. playoffs are set. It'll be the Wave, Blast, Comets, and Silver Knights of Syracuse vying for the title this year as Oliviero is fouled in the corner. That was Elaine Matingo, recently acquired a couple of weeks ago.
Matingu.
Elaine Matingu taking the foul there. In it comes. LSO rips one for three. Shots blocked. Comets did a good job of stepping up and blocking shots the last time these teams played. Actually, what they really did was did a great job of getting legs in the passing lane. Shot by Kiddos, just off the mark. Good crack by Victor. And up ahead, Gibson trying to walk in. He shoots. Good save there by Feinstra. Feinstra stopping Gibson on the breakaway that time. Now LSO looks up for Oliviero. Giuliano, nutmeg pass, gets it across as Liete and Oliveira try to work a 1-2. 10 seconds go in the period as Greenfield has it. Jonathan turns, trying to push up. Greenfield coming to the corner, but not going to get a shot off as the clock will tick down. That'll do it for the first period. So an exciting first period in the books. The Comets grabbing the lead on the goal by Lucas Rodriguez. Meanwhile, Marcel Feinstra with a great stop on the league's leading scorer, Leo Gibson, to keep the Wave deficit at 2. At the end of 1, it's the Missouri Comets 2, the Milwaukee Wave nothing. We'll come back with the second period after this. This is Wave Soccer in the Major Indoor Soccer League.
I was a sleep specialist before sleep specialists were cool.
We're cool?
We're cool.
I believe it.
When it comes to mattresses, I've seen it all.
I know all the brands.
And I know all of the options.
I know what works
for every type of sleeper.
And we all know how to help you find the mattress and pillow
that's gonna be right for you.
At the end of the day, that's the most important thing.
That and you getting a good night's sleep.
And our 120-night sleep guarantee
means you can't make a mistake.
So see a Steinhoffel's certified sleep specialist.
Because a better night's sleep starts with a visit to Steinhoffel's today.
Missouri Comets on top of Milwaukee Wave 2-0 at the end of the first period. Take a look at some of the highlights. Some great saves by each goalkeeper in the first quarter.
Well, and then some shots that are high by the Wave. Those aren't saves. Those are shots over the top of goal. Three times the Wave shot over the top from long range.
There's a great save there by Marcel Feenstra. And again, Feenstra coming up big on Leo Gibson as he came down the middle. So some great saves and some close misses combining for our 2-0 score at the end of one. Wave kicks off in black. They go left to right as we look at the action here in the second period. Long run, Justin McKinney trying to get there. Judson, a second-year player, first year with the Wave out of the University of Cincinnati. Now, seeing if he could put one through for J.C. Banks. Judson gets it back. Judson walking in. Again to J.C. Back heel to the middle. Knocked away by Waltman. And cleared out by the Comets. Fabinho will get there for the Wave. Fabinho and McKinney, the defenders right now. J.C., nice little back heel. McKinney coming through, deflected wide. McKinney diving with the header, but couldn't get it past Brian Harris. And the foul going to be called on J.C. Banks.
Good work that time with McKinney and J.C. Banks in the attacking zone.
Brian Harris with it. The veteran defender out of UMKC. I believe you've got four UMKC Kangaroos on this Comets roster. They've had some pretty good players come out of there. Nick Pereira. Pereira drives some three! Save made Waltman. Pereira, good job to get the rebound. Lays it back to the near wing. Now Tony Walls. Tony trying to get around Ivanovic. Tony gets it back. Running onto it. Everton. Little move. Everton shot blocked. Bennett. Everton still trying to get it. Fontana trying to get a leg in there. As Ryan Perez pushes it forward, we get an injured player for the Comets, and it's Alex Megson.
Good pressure sustained there by the Wave to open up this second quarter. Great save by Waltman on Pereira as that shot was headed for the upper left-hand corner.
Let's take another look and see if we can pick up how Alex Megson got hurt. Looked like he was holding his knee. You see Alex, oh my goodness. Stepped right in there with J.C. Banks, it looked like, and unlucky for Alex as they bump knees. And we were just talking earlier, Art, about what a fine addition Megson has been to this Comets team. In his fourth year in the MISLs, played with Chicago, Syracuse, among others. And this will be a tough loss for the Comets if he is out going into the postseason.
You look at their roster, they don't have a lot of guys that play defender to begin with. They've lost Cody Andrews. You mentioned Ryan Young, who played for them last year. And if Megson can't continue in this one, it's going to force Vladko Andonoski to make an adjustment. If he can't go, you would think that he'd probably move Ossidpor, their captain, back to the back line. Other than that, it might be Leo Gibson, who has played in the back as well. But if you take Ossidpor or Leo Gibson out of your midfield forward rotation, that certainly takes away from your ability to attack.
No doubt. Andonoski, the first-year coach of the Comets. He took over for Kim Rutfed, who managed the team the first 3 years as Megson comes off to the side. And, you know, we hope Alex is going to be okay.
Certainly a good sign that he's able to walk off under his own power. And hopefully he can walk that off and get right back in there.
Megson this year, 19 games, 9 goals and assists for 19 points.
You saw J.C. Banks.
Or Everton, his, that was. Excuse
me. Everton, yeah.
He stepped in there. So we'll see if Megson's going to be able to get back in there. Comets already without Cody Andrews, as we mentioned, out with that broken ankle. And apparently going to finish out the season without the recalcitrant Byron Alvarez, who has been their all-time leading scorer the past 3 seasons. But after him has shot in the goal, Brian Perez puts it away, 4-0 Missouri. Anyway, Perez upset with management after a deal fell through with St. Louis, and he's apparently going to sit out the rest of the season.
Well, Byron just never got it going this season for Missouri, but great ball here by Ivanovic, number eight. Watch this left-footed pass across, and Kiros just off Perez a little bit. And in this game, Tom, that's all you need is a little space in the box to finish. The Wave has got to put a body on the Missouri attackers. That's Ryan, the second goal in their own penalty area.
Ryan Perez with his 10th of the year, the Costa Rican native, another former UMKC Kangaroo. Scores at 2:05 of the second period to make it 4-0. And Ivanovic gets his fourth assist, 18 points. Wave coming down, ball to flex out. Wave will get a corner kick. Danny Waltman, very focused today thus far between the pipes for the Missouri Comets. Marcio Leite to play it from the corner. Marcio, who had a big game last night, 8 points, and now is in a tie for third place in the league scoring race. Touches in, Everton shot, knocked down, flicked to middle, San Luis headed it out for the Comets. Ian Bennett controls at midfield. Bennett will leave it for Jonathan Greenfield. As Greenfield will bring it forward into the corner, Everton. Everton tried to touch back for Leite. Couldn't make the connection. Sent back the other way. Judson McKinney is there to get it. Wave, as I mentioned, 8-1 at the U.S. Cellular Arena this year. The only loss coming to the Comets last Sunday. All-time regular season since 2003-04. The Wave, 117 wins against just 33 losses. Near conversion for Milwaukee that time. And we're got a foul coming up against the Comets. As you saw the near miss that time on the crack by McKinney, Fabinho trying to push in. Greenfield sends it across! And the redirection in tight by surprise, gathered in by Waltman. Out for Brian Harris. Harris with a touch through. Rodriguez takes a shot, blocked. Comes to the corner. Ooh, Greenfield got away with a foul that time as he bumped Gibson from behind. And picked up by Waltman. Now Pereira midfield for the Wave. Still plenty of time to go first half. 11 minutes to go, 4-0. The Missouri Comets on goals by Rodriguez and Perez have taken the lead. Trying to dump it into Pereira. Cleared out. Wave will kick it in front of their own bench. Wave Soccer is brought to you in part by the Frater and Medical College of Wisconsin Sports Medicine Center. As the Wave able to get on the board, Nick Pereira, it's 4-2.
Good ball that time by Tony Walls off the restart, and the big fellow Nick Pereira gets up and heads it over Waltman. The ball hit the crossbar, came back, and I believe it deflected off Waltman, Tom, and in behind the Missouri netminder. Let's take another look here. All started with a quick restart. You get a good look from behind the goal. Watch the big fellow get up. And you see that ball deflect back off Waltman and into his own cage.
So Pereira at 2:44 has got the Wave on the board. He gets his 18th goal of the year, 51 points now, which puts him 1 point ahead of Carlos Munoz on the Wave's scoring list. Nick also with 13 assists this year. Tony Walls will get credit for the assist. Tony, the rookie out of Tosi East High School in UW Green Bay, getting his fifth assist of the year and now 12 points.
Good awareness that time on the part of Walls to see Pereira alone behind the Missouri defense.
Again, Wave Soccer brought to you in part by Sprecher Root Beer, Ansay & Associates, Milwaukee Panther Athletics, Chipotle Mexican Grill, Badger Max, Robert Hack Diamonds, and the Wisconsin Lottery. We thank all of our fine sponsors along the way here for the 2013-14 season. Coming across, shot by Walls, knocked down. Oliviero gets it back. He sends it back in off the glass. And Waltman will outrace Bennett there to clear downfield. Kiddos will head it back to Marcel Feenstra. And the Wave once again on the attack, going left to right. Flicked out of there, it will stay in play. Gibson, nice little flick over his shoulder for Perez coming through. LSO there to run it off, but it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Oliveira, who better
be
careful. He's
careful there, right?
As he playfully gives a little shove there to Ryan Perez.
You look at all three goals that have been scored in this game, Tom. They've all been inside the penalty area. Safe to say the team that can defend more effectively inside their penalty area is probably going to get a result in this game.
Out of the corner, Perez will trigger for Missouri. In it comes. Gibson cracks a three. That one wide. Rodriguez heads it down. Harris, and he'll knock it back for Waltman.
So important you establish a goal side position inside your own penalty area and then get a body, wrap players up. Missouri's done a really good job of being close to the Milwaukee forwards so far in this game.
Harris cracks a three, but Oliviero right there to block it. Nice crowd here on the regular season finale for the Wave, and don't forget, Milwaukee will be right back here at the U.S. Cellular Arena. As Oliviero draws the foul, Brian Harris can't believe it is. Yeah. Oliviero just fell down on his own, it would appear, at midfield. But a crafty veteran gets the call. Anyway, Wave will be here to face either the St. Missouri Comets or the Syracuse Silver Knights on Monday, March 10th, 7 o'clock in the MISL playoffs. Kiddo centering, and the left foot redirection by Pereira knocked down in the middle.
Well, that ball might have been going in, but it hit Fontana in front after Pereira had redirected the pass from Karros.
For Wave playoff ticket information, check out the Wave website at MilwaukeeWave.com or call 414-224-WAVE. Pereira with another crack, deflected off Braithwaite out near the top of the area. Harris trying to muck his way through, and foul going to be called, I guess, for a dangerous play on Harris.
See Brian Harris, he picked up his second foul very quickly there. Harris has scored 14 goals this year, Tom, seven against the Milwaukee Wave.
He and Mike Lookinland for Baltimore are probably the two guys are going to duel it out for Defender of the Year. I'd say Lookinland probably the favorite right now, but Harris has had a fine year.
Yes, he has. He actually has 5 3-point goals, Tom. Four of those goals have come against the Wave. Been a real Wave killer so far this year.
Liete dropping one back for Kiddos. Almost a disaster there, but they get it back. McKinney and Kiddos, the defensive backfield right now for the Wave. Into the corner. Harris trying to clear, puts it in the stands, but I believe it hit the glass. So they'll have to kick it in front of the bench. Media timeout at 7:21 of the second quarter, with the Comets still leading 4-2. Let's send it down to Van McNeil.
Oh, hi, Van. Hey, I'm hanging out here with the Skywalk Pharmacy hero of the game. Meet Mr. Bradley and his mom, Jessica. Bradley's 15 months old, and his mom tells me he's been in heart failure since the day he was born. He is currently missing half of his heart, and there are no treatment available. But he's thriving, full of life, and we wish you all, your entire family, the best of luck. Back to you, Van.
Nicole Coughlin and our Skywalk Pharmacy hero of the game, 15-month-old Bradley. Thanks for coming, Bradley. Thanks, family. Find out more, skywalkpharmacy.com.
All right, so we are ready to resume here in the middle of the second period, 7:21 left to go. Tom went along with the Wave Hall of Famer, Art Kramer. You see Vlatko Andonovsky talking things over with his team, the Missouri Comets, in front of their bench.
A couple positives so far here from the Wave, Tom. They've done a good job of taking care of the ball in their own zone.
yesterday against St. Louis. They kicked the ball out of play from their own defensive third five times, which resulted in a high volume of restarts against the Wave. So far, they've done a really good job. You see Joe Hamas there pictured in your screen, sitting there with local coach Nick Martinez.
Both Joe Hamas, one of the Wave all-time greats, defenders, retired after last season, after an outstanding 10-year career. Cedarburg native, former Milwaukee Marquette High star and St. Louis University star.
Yeah, current director of coaching for the North Shore United Soccer Club. There's Joe.
All right, Wave to put it in play. As Liete trying to battle across is checked off of the play by Ramon Palmer. Sent through. San Luis clears it. Palmer starts it back. Ramon Palmer, number 5. Robert Palmer, when he plays, is number 12. Take away Fabinho. Fabinho trying to get past Harris, but Harris having none of it. And his clearance kept in, but Fabinho got called for the foul there as he helps Harris up. He gave him a pretty good crack down there.
Good defensive play at midfield by Fabinho to start that play. Then got over a little over anxious there in the attack.
6:45 left to go here in the first half. Comets got the first four in this contest. Rodriguez and Perez each netting 2-point goals. Wave then coming back on the goal by Nick Pereira to draw within two. Top of the area. Max Talut trying to make a move. Got cut off. Now Stefan San Luis with it. San Luis, a former star for the Golden Grizzlies of Oakland University in Rochester, Michigan. Now a member of the Horizon League after many years in the Summit League. Coming through, and the shot by Lucas Rodriguez turned away. Phil Surprise comes up with it. Finds J.C. Banks up on the near board, but the Comets get it back. And now Braithwaite got cut off as the Comets still control. Perez with a 3-point drive, save made by Feinstra. Back off the inboard. Sidewinding effort by Banks to clear the zone. Comets still with it, keeping the pressure on. And good job by Banks to get up, block that shot by Ivanovic. Feinstra steps out to play it. Now Banks will start upfield. And well done by the rookie there to keep the possession.
One of the keys for the Wave, Tom, is when they win the ball in their own third of the field, to connect three passes to break down that pressure from Missouri. Something the Wave really struggled with yesterday against St. Louis.
Here's LSO, drives one in wide right. Braithwaite trying to push it ahead, but the Wave gets it back. Now McKinney, pressure from Braithwaite, who continues all the way up the, or Talut, I should say. Now, Ian Bennett trying to come up, trying to make it a 3-2 as he's clipped from behind by Talut.
Well, if you're going to call a foul there, you've got to pull the card as well, because that really takes away a 3-on-2 break for the Wave. Take another look. This is from the wrong side. Oh, and actually, he got the ball. I don't know if I would even call the foul there.
And it comes on the restart. Shot by Bennett, knocked down. Ian trying to follow, and that one blocked out of bounds. Wave will kick it in from the near point. Again, the Comets really doing a great job to step up and block shots in front of their goalkeeper, Waltman, thus far today. Now Oliviero centering on the play, directed back to the corner. Giuliano trying to get it. McKinney jumping in there, but the Comets clear the zone. Tony Walls will eventually get there for the Wave. Tony turns and able to get through at midfield. Now Bennett with it. Finds Oliviero. Well, I don't know how Tony got through there, but he was able to do so. McKinney launches three, knocked down. Bennett with a little chip. Oh, just high. Had the right idea, but just a little too high. He knew Waltman was down, and he was just trying to loft it over him, but just got it up a little too high. Gibson trying to get away from Walls. Ball pops free to the middle as Ramon Palmer trying to get it. Look at Fontana. Marcello now trying to come 2-1 with Liete, but Comets getting back. Marcio got it on the left foot in the shot up in the stands. Stokic with a good defensive effort to slide over and make him hurry the shot.
Take a look at that save by Danny Waltman on McKinney. And as you said, Tom, Bennett tried to just chip it over the top of Waltman's head, but just got a little too much on it.
3:35 to go in the half. Fast moving first half here. No penalties. We haven't had a lot of fouls called thus far by Shane Butler and Mark Kudlasik.
A real playoff type game, Tom. Tight defensively. Both teams doing a really good job inside their own penalty areas.
Acid pour to Gibson. And tried to play one around. It comes out top. Bouncing shot by Acid pour, wide right. Acid pour, the veteran out of Detroit Mercy. Originally from the Toronto, Ontario area. And after initially beginning his career with the Detroit Ignition, has come over to Missouri and been a real solid presence in that lineup for the Comets.
Well, he's their captain, and not only is he a big-time scoring presence, but he also gives you great composure on the ball and provides a lot of leadership for Vladko Andonovski and the Comets.
Valiente. Greenfield, surprise, trying to get around his man. Phil, surprise, trying to turn the corner. Sosa wouldn't let him do it. Back out it comes, and Nick Pereira mishitting that one up into the stands.
Love the aggressive run forward that time by Phillip Surprise. Missouri's going to try to get five behind the ball quickly. It's important the Wave tries to attack and beat them down the floor when that's on.
Now, Marcia Leite trying to come on a change. But they wouldn't let him. Comets in blue, they go right to left here in the second period. Just over 2 minutes left to go. 4-2, Missouri has it. Remember, Missouri's home playoff date as the number 3 seed is going to be Sunday at the Independence Event Center. 3 p.m. Central Time kickoff. So check out their website at MissouriComets.com for you Comets fans interested in coming out to see that game, which will take place either between the Comets and the Wave or the Comets and the Blast.
Tom, Coach Tozer hasn't used a timeout yet. Is that correct? So if the Wave gets a restart down here in the zone, expect Coach to take his timeout. He gets 3 per game, but no more than 2.5.
Into the corner. Everton. Double team. Got it back out, Fabinho. Now Everton back for Fabinho, trying to get top of the area, and it came over to LSO, and he cracks one up in the stands. And remember, if it's Missouri against the Wave in the MISL semifinals, it would be this Sunday, March 9th, 3 p.m. in Missouri at the Independence Event Center, and then game 2 and game 3 minigame, if necessary, would be the following day, Monday, March 10th, 7 p.m. Central Time here at the U.S. Cellular Arena.
I think one of Coach Tozer's points at halftime has got to be to concentrate on your long-range shooting. It's been too many shots over the top of the goal, whether it's been on the glass above Waltman or up into the crowd. Got to get those shots on frame. As we saw before, Waltman will give you a rebound. It's important for the way they keep those shots on frame.
As we approach the one-minute mark, Waltman looking up for Stefan Saint-Louis, being dogged that time by Victor Quiros. Back for Harris. Comets very patient right now with this possession. I think they would be very content to take a lead in the locker room at halftime. Ball deflects, Judson McKinney with it. McKinney, nice look to J.C. Banks on the near wing. J.C. trying to get it on the left foot. He does! Shot in! Safe Waltman through traffic. McKinney gets it back. Oh! Oliviero looking for LSO. Couldn't quite make the connection at the post. Still 20 seconds to go in the half. Gibson and McKinney battling along with LSO and Ivanovic, who comes away with it. Wave keeping the pressure on. Oliviero. Now McKinney. Turns, plays one to the far side, and that's going to do it. Good pressure by the Wave in the waning seconds, but unable to come up with that tying goal. So, pretty intense, exciting first half. Let's take a look how the Wave got on the board here. As Nick Pereira converts off the long pass from Sony Walls, a little skirmish here, Art, as the teams head for the locker room.
Yeah, Marcelo Fontana wasn't happy about something. Both teams right now still around the yellow line. Coach Tozzi, you see him trying to pull his players away. John Sosa, number 19 for Missouri, telling his team to get to the locker room. Well, there you see Gibson once again. He's still at it right there.
He can be a bit volatile at times on the field, as evidenced by a few red cards in his career.
Fahid Asadpour talking with Shane Butler, trying to state his case. And there's the two coaches, Keith Tozer and Vladko Andonovsky. Let's see what happens with these two guys. Coach trying to pull everybody away.
See Martello now talking with fellow Argentinian Lucas Rodriguez.
Couple Argentinians. Marcello is pointing the finger saying, okay, man, it's on in the second half. Don't go anywhere.
Stay tuned for this one, fans. Wave trainer Larry Sales fired up for this one as we come to halftime. It's a Missouri Comets 4, Milwaukee Wave 2. We'll come back with the Badger Max halftime show. This is Milwaukee Wave Soccer in the Major Indoor Soccer League.
All right, now time for the Badger Max halftime show. First thing up for bids, the Steinhoffel's mattress roll. Three contestants will have to roll from right here at midfield. First to score a goal will take home a dream mattress courtesy of Steinhoffel's. Let's meet our contestants. Your name, where are you from?
Rob, and I'm from Fox Point.
You sure?
Yes.
Washington County?
Nope.
Ozaukee?
Nope.
Where?
Milwaukee County.
Milwaukee, all right. Fox Point, all right, I suppose.
Rich from Milwaukee.
All right, Rich from Milwaukee. And?
Gary from the Falls.
Gary up in the Falls. All right, Menominee Falls in the house. These three contestants have to roll from midfield to the yellow line and then score a goal. First one to do so wins a dream mattress courtesy of Steinhoffel's. When you're ready, here we go. On your marks, get set, go. Oh, problems right off the bat. Oh my goodness. Blues first to the yellow, and you gotta get up and shoot the goal. That's the tough part. Here we go. There's a winner right there. Congratulations to our Steinhoffel's mattress roll winner. Enjoy your dream mattress from Steinhoffel's. Are you all right? You good?
Dizzy.
I know you're dizzy. That's the point of the game. If you haven't noticed, Wave fans, we have an IndyCar just over there in the southeast corner of the field, thanks to our friends at Milwaukee Indy Fest. We got all the nice cars here. IndyCars over there. Bring out the Alfa Romeo, would you? Time now for the Soccer Scramble, brought to you by Town Bank. No, you do not win the Alfa Romeo. I know. I would love to win it as well. Purchased mini balls can now be thrown into the back. One lap. All right, last chance. Get those mini balls in there. You got one? He's got the winner already. Congratulations to ball number 235. 235, you are a soccer scramble winner. Congratulations over to section 210 to claim your prize. That's how you do the soccer scramble, brought to you by Town Bank. All right, David, Nancy, David, get out here. Come on, David. What the what? What is going on here, ladies and gentlemen? From your Milwaukee Bucks. Forward number 34, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Giannis Antetokounmpo. That's the closest I'm going to get, Giannis. From your Milwaukee Bucks game last night, thanks for coming here today. I understand you brought the family, right?
Yeah, I brought the family here. You know, I want to thank Sue Black that invited me here to watch the game, and go Wave.
Absolutely, and go Bucks, right?
Introduce his two little brothers.
All right, and who are your brothers here?
Hey, here is Costas, 16 years old, and go to Dominican High School, and here is my brother Alex, and he go to Saint Monica.
Oh my goodness! How about a hand here, Giannis? Antetokounmpo. There we go. So now you got to make a goal. All right, it's time for the Reina kick with your Milwaukee Bucks. So here's what we're going to do. Giannis, midfield with the ball. You got to get it right through the center hole. Now, wait a minute, Giannis. Sue Black met you at practice over at the Cousins Center, and you got some skills. You got some soccer skills, huh?
Do you want him to show you?
Yeah, let's see. Let's see here. Let's see. Come on, Giannis. Here we go. We got to get him some. Oh, you got to get all the stuff out of the. Giannis Antetokounmpo. He's got the skills. But. Hey, let's get a jersey on this guy. All right, Giannis. You've got the juggling skills, Giannis, but do you have the precision? Do you have the aim to make it through the center hole? Fans, what do you think? He's got this, right? Giannis Antetokounmpo, here we go. Wait a second, wait. Let's hook him up again one more time. He's gonna get this, fans. Love how he just picks up the ball. Come on, Giannis, you can hit this. Uh-oh, maybe. Maybe! Oh! One more time? One more for Giannis. Let's get a ball over here. Fans, show him the love. He's got this. I know he's got this. For the scooter. We've got a winner! We have got a winner! Let's take a look at the replay up on the video board and the sweet shot. Giannis.
Oh my gosh, you guys, was that awesome or what? Let's give it up for him again. again in the family. We were going to give him some soccer balls and stuff, but he just took off. One more thing, David Gruber. Everybody, let's thank him for the T-shirts today. Van does it better, but what do? One call? All right.
Thank you, Sue. Thank you, David. And one more time, Giannis.
Take it easy. What?
All right. Do we have time? We got time for, come on over. We need our real contestant here. Come on over. How are you going to follow that up, man? What is your name?
Nathan.
Where are you from?
I'm from Dousman, Ottawa.
All right, Nathan over there in Dousman. Let's go. Let's go. Can he follow Giannis? Whenever you're ready, Nathan, fire at will. All right, thank you, Nathan. Nice try. Let's bring out the envelopes. Five contestants now. Time for the Let's Make a Deal Fan Appreciation Game Extravaganza. Let's bring out our prizes. So much to win. Thank you so much for the proper music. Five contestants have been picked after signing up in the concourse. Five envelopes. Each contestant will pick an envelope. But there's a catch. The contestant I can either take the envelope. All right, I'll come to you. All right, right here. Line them up. One, two, three, four, five. They've gotten their envelopes. Number one, stay right. Why are you guys moving? Stop. Your name and where you're from?
Don Shelley, Waukesha.
Do you want to keep what's in the envelope, or do you want the mystery prize?
I'll stay with this one.
You're going to stay with this one. Your name and where you're from?
Andrew, Jackson, Wisconsin.
Jackson, what do you think we got in here for you?
I have no idea.
Oh, you want what's in the envelope, or do you want the mystery prize?
I want to keep what's in here.
You're going to keep what's in there. Okay. All right. No risk takers today. Your name and where you're from?
Candy from Milwaukee.
All right, Candy. Envelope?
Keeping.
Or you're keeping it?
Yep.
All right, Candy. Next, who's got an envelope? Your name, where are you from?
Chris from Brookfield.
Chris from Brookfield. Okay, Chris, you're going to take the envelope?
I'll take the mystery envelope.
He's going to take the mystery envelope, ladies and gentlemen. So four goes back in there. All right, we'll see what we get here in a minute. Your name, where are you from?
Jay from Brookfield.
Jay from Brookfield. The envelope or his envelope? What's it going to be?
It's like lucky number four.
Oh, a little bit of a change here. All right. Range of prizes include Southwest Airlines tickets, bikes from Wheel and Sprocket. So much to give away here. All right, let's take our envelopes. Let's open them all at once. Three, two, one, hold up your prizes to the window. Beer for a year from Beer Capital for you. A bike for you from Wheel and Sprocket. A Master Lock toolbox for you. Southwest Airlines tickets in the mystery for you. And a Sprecher Brewery tour and a big package valued at about $200 for you from our friends at Sprecher. And then our last prize here, Sarah, let's open up the envelope. Section 208, row 8, seat 9. A 50-inch flat panel television for you, courtesy of ABC Audio and Video for you, sir. That's how you do the Let's Make a Deal extravaganza, all part of your fan appreciation game here with your Milwaukee Wave. How about some T-shirts? Would you like a T-shirt or two? You got to make some noise. Time now for the Eggers Imprints T-shirt toss.
right. Welcome back to the Badger Max Halftime Show. Badger Max, premium sports drinks for all of your athletic endeavors. Online at BadgerMax.com. Take a look at some of the highlights in the first half. And not a ton of scoring chances to go around, but the goalkeepers certainly denying some good ones for both sides. And then eventually the Comets will draw first blood on this unassisted goal by Lucas Rodriguez. He has torched the Wave in the last several games they played. And then Milan Ivanovic setting up Brian Perez to make it 4-0. Wave has come close a few times. They've hit the frame several long blasts. Then they finally got one on the long serve from Tony Walls to Nick Pereira, as just able to get it up and off of Waltman on the deflection. As you saw Elaine take one there in the chops for the Comets. And again, Danny Waltman and his counterpart, Marcel Fainter, for the Wave, coming to the forefront. Both keepers with some outstanding work in the first half to keep this score at 4-2 Comets. Brad Beach showing off his moves there, trying to see if he can get this crowd ready for the second half. A little bit of skirmish there, Art, at the end of the first half. I didn't really see exactly what happened, but certainly Marcelo Fontana for the Wave, very enraged, as was Leo Gibson for the Missouri Comets.
Looked like Fontana had some words for Leo Gibson, the high-scoring forward, number 14 for the Missouri Comets. You saw Vlad Kojandanoski, the Missouri head coach, in there as well, trying to get his team back to the locker room. But how about halftime, Tom? Giannis Antetokounmpo from the Bucks comes out and hits a half-court shot. Wow. One of the few shots the Bucks have hit this year, but Antetokounmpo, the Greek international. Yep.
That was pretty amazing, and that's the kind of tape you'd seen maybe leading off an ESPN Sports Center. All right, Wave with it in the black uniforms. They go right to left to start the third period. Shot in, cleared out by the Comets as they start back the other way. Leo Gibson running onto it. And his shot turned away by Feinstra. Again, Gibson, the league's leading scorer, 76 points coming in. Has not registered a point yet tonight, but his nearest competitor is the Wave's Ian Bennett, who has 64 points. So I would say the scoring championship is just about there for Gibson.
The Wave has done a good job on Gibson. In fact, the last two games, two times these teams have met, the Wave has shut Gibson out.
Yeah, that's quite a credit to the Milwaukee's defense, that's for sure. Yeah, erupted for 8 points, I believe it was, the other night against the St. Louis Ambush. And that pretty much decided the scoring race, with Ian Bennett being held to just 2 points last night's game against the Ambush. Again, the Comets, with a couple days off from their previous game to this one, and the Wave with a quick turnaround after last night's game here against St. Louis.
The Comets were able to fly in early and come to yesterday's game. They were in the stands watching the Wave face off against St. Louis.
Marcelo Fontana called for the foul. Cello still might be a bit wound up from the end of the first half. Remember, the MISL, you get 3 personal fouls in each half on your fourth one. Your team gives up a 2-minute power play. Pereira trying to take away from Braithwaite. Could not quite do it. Some pretty good work there by Andre Braithwaite. And now the Wave on the counterattack. Starts it back. 3-on-2 with Pereira in the middle. He's got Fontana and also Kittles. Fontana looked far post, knocked down. Pereira following, and shot is off the mark. Fabinho gets it. He'll play it back for Marcio Liente.
One of the few odd man rushes that time for the Wave. 3-2. Good job by Missouri defensively.
Liente plays it off. Judson McKinney. Now Liete on the exchange. Shot blocked by San Luis. Pereira turning. Pereira bouncing shot. Save made. Waltman. And he covers it up.
Good piece of skill by the big fella, Nick Pereira, that time. And Waltman with another good save.
Early going third period. Still 4-2 Comets. Fajitas Odpor back in the lineup after missing four games with a strained knee. What are your thoughts on how he looks so far, Art?
Well, once again, he brings that leadership to this team. And as he said before, it looks like Vladko Andonovski has moved Odpor to the back with the injury to Alex Megson.
And obviously, he wanted to get Odpor on the field at least once before the postseason. See what he's got. To me, it looks like he's moving okay out there. Maybe not a 1,000%, but he's appears to be pretty close to it.
Just one of those types of players, Tom, that never looks like he's exuding too much energy. Very, very fluid player. Reminds me so much of Omid Namazi.
Good comparison, yeah. Not quite as stocky as Omid, but as far as reading the game, and like you said, always in the right position at the right time. Probably a little more skilled than Omid as far as offensive capabilities, but yeah, very, very similar. Odpor, who's also a player assistant coach, I would think he could be a pretty good coach in this league going forward as well when his playing days are done.
Omid, a former defender, all-star defender in this league and coach in this league, and most recently an assistant coach for the Iranian national team that just qualified for the 2014 World Cup.
So Omid will indeed be on his way to Brazil with the Iranian contingent. Omid, a former West Virginia University Mountaineer back in his college days.
Actually, Omid's contract was not renewed with the Iran national team, so as he was helpful in getting them to the World Cup, is not going to be part of that contingent in Brazil. But
boy, that's great. Thanks, but no thanks.
Hey, it's a business, man. It is a business.
Matingu trying to keep it in play on the far side, couldn't quite do it. So the Wave will bring it up. Milwaukee in black going right to left. Tony Walls just a little bit high as he was chipping down for Oliviero. Juliana was trying to say that was outside the corner flag, but instead, well, I guess they are going to confirm it. Jules may be 40 years old, but his eyes are still very sharp. So no goal kick or goal throw for the Comets. They got to play it in from there. The Wave gets it back. Greenfield and Walls, the defenders right now, with Oliviero, Oliveira, and Bennett running up front. Greenfield against Perez. We'll play it up for Ian Bennett. Now Greenfield played up Oliviero. Tried to move it across for Bennett. Got cut off there, popped up in the air to the near wing by Rodriguez. Greenfield gets it back. Greenfield finds LSO. LSO will take the right foot shot blocked by Rodriguez. And he felt that one as he comes up lipping a little bit. Oh, that's a good compliment to LSO with the right foot. Normally his strong foot is the left foot.
You said it, Rodriguez limping. I would have liked to seen Luan go right at Rodriguez off the dribble, recognizing that he was injured.
Greenfield backing the left footer up in the stands, and a goal throw coming now for Danny Waltman. There you see Waltman, the veteran out of the University of Washington, originally from Gig Harbor, Washington. Yeah, Lucas Rodriguez still wincing in pain there a little bit as he stuck out a leg to block that shot by Oliveira.
Well, anytime you reach across your body and block with the outside of your foot, you run the risk that you don't provide a very good foundation to support that leg.
Ryan Harris for the Comets, moving it up. Two other games going on in the Major Indoor Soccer League today. We will try to give you some updated scores there. That's Baltimore at Pennsylvania and Rochester at Syracuse. Foul called against the Comets. Today's Milwaukee Wave game is brought to you in part by the Freighter and the Medical College of Wisconsin Sports Medicine Center, Badger Max, Professional Construction Incorporated of Waukesha, Wisconsin, West Bend Mutual, the silver lining and sponsor of our silver lining three-point goals scored by the Wave. The Guardian Credit Union, Quaker Steak and Lube, Elite Fitness and Racquet Clubs, and Keeper Goals, official equipment supplier of Wisconsin Youth Futsal. Great to have all those sponsors aboard. Greenfield in the middle, but he was sealed off by Ivanovic that time. Couldn't get a foot on it. Waltman picks it up. Out for Harris. Trying to come forward out of the back. Takes a shot and saved by Feinstra as he covered up the short side.
It's one thing the Wave has got to be aware of is that quick transition by Brian Harris, number 25 for Missouri, out of the back. That time Waltman was able to find Harris very quickly on the counter.
All right, John Sosa out of the corner. Now he will let Perez run past. Sosa lays it off top of the area. Vahid Asadpour pours it into the nets, and the Comets lead it 6-2. Restart goal by Asadpour and the Comets at 6:44 of the third period.
Well-designed restart that time by Missouri. They started with a runner over the ball, which forced the Wave to drop back defensively, and you saw Asadpour with the left foot. Not a whole lot Feinstra could do. Fabinho was tied up in front with the Missouri attacker.
20th goal of the year for Asadpour. Sosa gets his 20th assist. Second on the team to Leo Gibson, who leads the league with 25. Asadpour, 57 points now in just 16 games. He was sixth in the league scoring race coming in. And once again, the Comets up by four. Comets win. They will take on the Wave in the first round of the playoffs, the semifinals. That would be game one Sunday at the Independence Event Center at 3 o'clock Central Time. Game two, Monday, March 10th, the following night, here from the U.S. Cellular Arena, 7 o'clock Central Time. Comets fans, check MissouriComets.com for ticket information. Wave fans, check MilwaukeeWave.com or call 414-224-WAVE to order your tickets. Foul going to be called on, looks like, Andre Brithwaite. Restart chance for the Wave. Kiros quickly gets it in. Everton takes a shot, and Waltman just able to cover up before it trickled over the line.
Waltman fortunate that time. The ball went off the back wall, redirected off Danny's body, and almost got in behind him, as was the case in the first goal by the Wave by Pereira.
Quick restart. Wave almost able to convert there. Now surprise back for Feinstra. Nicely done, though, as he played it out to Jason Banks, who lost possession, but Rodriguez deflected into the stands. Let's take a look at that last save by Waltman with the goal line view. It almost trickled up. Remember, the whole ball has to go across the line, so it wasn't really that close. Let's send it down to Van McNeil.
Thank you, Tom. Back up from Fox 6 Wake Up News in Real Milwaukee, Nicole Coughlin. Nicole, who are you hanging with?
Hey, Van. I'm up in Section 324 right now with the Wave of Hope board members and the fine folks from Urban Ecology Center. Recipients of today's $1,000 check, here is Sue Black.
I couldn't be more proud today to give this check to the Urban Ecology Center. I've always been a huge fan of their cause, the kids, the environment, everything that they do. And all the volunteers that helped out today, thank you so much. But Ken Lineback is really the leadership behind it. And Ken, you do an amazing job for the community. And thank you so much. And I'm proud to give this to you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we love the Wave, we love Sue, and we love the check. So thanks a lot. And the board is fantastic, so it could and the mascot's great. And I could go on, but I won't.
Okay. Congratulations, Van, back to you.
Thank you, Nicole. Nicole Coughlin from Fox 6 Wake Up News in Real Milwaukee, along with our friends, our charity of the game. Thanks again, Urban Ecology Center.
All right, the Wave trailing 6-2, but they almost snuck one in on that shot by Everton.
Once again, important to get shots on target. The Wave just missing the frame by inches here this afternoon on numerous occasions.
Well, they say it's a game of inches.
let's put it this way. What sport is not a game of inches? Not too many of them, that's for sure.
It's a fine line, Tom, between winning and losing. We've seen that the past 2 years. The Wave win the championship against Baltimore on a restart that just sneaks through. Gets knocked out last year by Missouri on a restart that just trickles in against them.
LSO being harassed out near the midfield stripe, gets over to Greenfield. Into the corner now, Oliviero. Giuliano got a piece of it. Back out to the point, Greenfield. Jonathan backing up on the ball as Ivanovic keeps track of him. Now lets LSO circle behind, goes far side. Here's Tony Walls into Oliviero, and as Tony was trying to go past, he was dumped by Gibson.
I like the approach that time by Walls. Get it wide and then attack the defender off the dribble. That time he tried to give and go with Oliviero. Wave's going to have to attack the flanks, get balls off the boards, and get runners into the box.
Greenfield will drill one from three. Cleared out. Greenfield gets it back. Well, Jonathan's had a couple of good strikes out there on the free kicks. Haven't been able to get one in yet, but at least he's striking the ball well today. Plays it across. Walls will go to the corner. Oliviero. Giuliano against Brian Harris. Harris able to take it away. Sends one up to midfield. Greenfield just gets there before Ivanovic. Again, a fast-moving game here today from the U.S. Cellular Arena. No penalties whistled as of yet by referees Shane Butler and Mark Kedlasic. LSL harassed out there by Matingu. Now Waltman's going to clear that one into the stands, but it did hit glass, so kicked in from the line.
Once again, a good approach there, Tom. Attacking down the flanks leads to a restart opportunity for the Wave.
Wave changes up everybody in the restart here. Liete drives it in, knocked down, gets it back. Now sends one in off the board and taken by Waltman. That's far a frustrating offensive day for the Wave. Playing pretty solidly defensively, only yielding 6 points up to this point, but just have not been able to gather a lot of offensive momentum at this point. Missouri Comets looking to win the season series versus the Wave for the first time in the four-year history of this rivalry. They won three of the first five, and they are going to be the only team to beat the Milwaukee Wave this year. Wave 16-3, all three losses to the Comets. So still only going to be Missouri that's going to have a chance to beat them in the regular season. Baltimore, on the other hand, lost twice to the Wave and once to Syracuse. Foul called as Stokic gets called for obstructing Marcelo Fontana. Mark Sedlacek shaking his head at whatever rationale Stokic was trying to provide there. Here's Nick Pereira trying to back his way down in the corner as Sosa was grabbing a hold of him. Foul was called.
Wave starting to generate a higher volume of restart opportunities in the Missouri attacking third. And now Sosa's going to go to the box for a yellow card descent, it appears.
Yeah, Sosa was protesting a bit too much down there. Now you see Vahid Hasanpour, the team captain, the assistant coach, trying to mitigate circumstances.
Actually, it looks like Leo Gibson that's going to go off.
The veteran from King's College in Tennessee will head to the box to cool off for a while. Definitely not a man that the Comets want to see in the box for at least 5 minutes.
And it's, you see the foul. Gibson said something there at the end.
No power play, but again, Gibson's going to be out for at least 5 minutes. He can't come in. After 5 minutes expires, he's got to wait for a substitution period to get back on there. So sometimes these can run 7 or 8 minutes, depending. Foul called on the Wave. So Sosa plays upfield. Judson McKinney there to get it. Now Liete for the wave. Milwaukee in black. They go right to left here in the third. Comets led it 2-0 at the end of one. 4-2 at halftime. It's now 6-2. McKinney's shot. Blocked. Judson trying to get it back, and it just squirts through and covered up by Waltman. Very quiet U.S. Cellular Arena right now.
Well, the wave remaining patient with their approach to drop off into their own half of the field. At some point, down by four, they're going to have to come out of that defensive tactic if this score remains the same.
Ooh, sent across. Feenstra comes out, and well, he had it for a moment. Fabinho able to cover up. Liete is checked down by Sosa. Sosa's got a couple of quick ones now here in the third.
Missouri doing a good job of bodying the Milwaukee players either on the ball or off the ball to not allow Milwaukee to counterattack quickly. They'd rather take the foul so they can set up defensively.
Yeah, they've been a good job tying up the wave in the neutral zone.
Yep.
Much like the New Jersey Devils made famous in the NHL. J.C. Banks, Wall sends one up around the glass. Now Everton near side. Kiddos. Everton coming back door, but he could not redirect it in as Waltman gathers it in. Wave trying just about everything in the half field set. Trying to manufacture some offense, but not having a lot of luck at this stage. 2.5 to go in the third. Once again for you, Missouri and Milwaukee fans, the home dates for the playoffs are Comets this Sunday, March 9th, 3 p.m. at the Independence Events Center. And for the Wave, Monday, March 10th, 7 p.m. here at the U.S. Cellular Arena. Check the respective websites for ticket information, MissouriComets.com and MilwaukeeWave.com. Well, Wave still sagging back, so the Comets going to knock it back and forth, use up a little time. Waltman sends it up ahead, Harris. Centering on the play, Kiddos is there to collect it. Victor will turn, lay it off for his defensive partner, Tony Walls. Oliviero off the bench, gets it to Kiddos. Far side, and the shot by Banks turned away. Walls keeps it alive for his former teammate at UW Green Bay. Oh, Tony topped the aerial.
Yeah, great opportunity to shoot first time off that pass from surprise.
Here's Banks, JC. And rolls one in, but Waltman able to cover up. Lobs out to midfield, Kiddos. Banks. And Banks trying to knock it ahead for Kiddos, but just put it up into the bench.
The Wave wanted a handball there in front of the bench. Not going to get it. You know, we mentioned Walls passing up that shot. There's not a lot of space in and around the area. When you get a little space, you better be firing away.
Final 35 seconds of the third period. Well, the two highest scoring teams in the league coming in, but again, as we mentioned, number two and three defensively. And you called it right from the start, Art, that the way both teams are going to approach this one, this was not going to be a high scoring affair. And it certainly has not been, only four goals combined. Still a possible chance for the Wave in the final 10 seconds. LSO, oh, nice tackle there as Palmer knocked it away. LSO cracks a three up into the stand. And it'll be a goalkeeper distribution for Danny Waltman and the Comets.
Well, 3 seconds left in this quarter, Tom. I got to think the Wave in the fourth quarter is going to come out, throw caution to the wind, and put a high-pressure defensive attack on the Comets.
We will see. Just one goal scored here in the third. Mahid Asipour, his 20th of the year,
Off a restart pass from John Sosa, who got his 20th assist as Keith Tozer will try and diagram some strategy to see if the Wave can have a little more offensive success here. 6-2 Missouri as we head to the fourth. This is Wave Soccer and the Major Indoor Soccer League.
Dear MKE is a love letter to the city of Milwaukee. It started as a series of short and brilliant documentaries, and then it grew into a chance for anyone who calls Milwaukee home to tell its stories. And who tells our stories better than us? Well, no one. Find the people, the places, the events that make this city so endearing. Write them up, take a picture, make a video, and then just upload it to DearMKE.com or use the hashtag DearMKE on Instagram or Twitter. I cannot wait to see your submission.
All right, here with our good friend from ABC Audio Video, they are the official entertainment provider of your Milwaukee Wave, Mr. Chris Klug. How's it going, Chris?
Very good, Van. How you doing?
Doing very well. Thanks for all the support this great season. Of course, a lot of fun stuff over there at ABC Audio Video. What are we giving away here?
We are giving away a 50-inch Toshiba flat panel TV, much like the one somebody won earlier today, and let's make a deal. Where is he? I can also hang that for you, but slight additional cost.
All right, let's pick a name. Is it going to be one of you guys? Who's the winner here? Chris, the winner is...
We have the winner, Jay Nelson.
Section 224, row 5, right there. A 50-inch flat panel TV courtesy of this man and ABC Audio Video. Chris, like I said, thank you for the support all season long. Visit those guys out in Waukesha, abcaudiovideo.com. It's over there in Port Washington. All right, it is fan appreciation game, so we have a lot to give away here. Ready for this? Get your ticket stubs out. Dinner for two. It's a $50 value at Bravo Cucina Italiana, section 122, row 3, seat 13. Dinner for two at Bravo, section 207, row 9, seat 2. A Welke's House of Roses gift card to the following section 209, row 8, seat 11. And section 225, row 5, seat 6. From Rodizio Grill, complimentary dinners for section 122, row 1, seat 1. And section 211, row 5, seat 8. Beer for a year. Section 326, row 9, seat 11. Courtesy of Beer Capital, two admissions to the Milwaukee Sports Show. Section 425, row 4, seat 2. Section 326, row 9, seat 13. Coors Light for sections 326, row 9, seat 2. 324, seat row 5, seat 7. More prizes to come.
There's the score, 6-2 Missouri as we head to the fourth period. Tom went along with Wave Hall of Famer Art Kramer. And Art, somehow the Wave's got to figure out a way to generate a little offense here in the fourth.
Well, it's time for the stars to show up to the dance here, Tom. Ian Bennett, Nick Pereira, Marcio Liete, Luan Oliveira. Now's the time.
Danny Waltman and the Comets defense has been outstanding thus far. And again, Marcel Veenstra, the Wave defense, has done a nice job to limit this high-scoring Comets team to 6 points, but Waltman and his defense just a little bit better up to this point. Comets with it. There's Waltman, the keeper. Broke into the MISL back in 2004-05 with the old Chicago Storm.
Here's the Wave's going to pressure man-to-man higher up the field, but they're not going to pressure the goalkeeper, Danny Waltman. But if the Wave's going to play this way, Missouri's just going to keep kicking it back to Waltman and killing clock.
And Greenfield will screen out his man. Picked up by Marcel Feenstra.
And I like the approach by Coach Tozer. It's still too early to abandon your game plan.
Everton trying to lay it back to McKinney as Everton was getting knocked down. And Sosa able to pry it away. San Luis taking away Everton. Centering shot and a goal. Wow. Comets thought there was a foul down there. Everton pretty aggressive going back after the ball, and he set up Fontana. And the way back within two at 6-4.
Good defensive pressure that time by Everton to win the ball in the corner. He finds Fontana in the box. Just what the doctor ordered for the Wave.
Well, we don't really see the play there by Everton. Saw the nice finish by Fontana. Well, you see the tail end, but again, play was made by Everton to take it away from the defender down there.
Well, it's been physical all game long in both teams' defensive third of the field. I actually think the Wave could have done a better job to this point of drawing fouls in the attacking third of the field because there's been a lot of contact.
Eighth of the year for Fontana. He's got goals now in back-to-back games. Now takeaway Milwaukee, Marcio Liete. Pushing ahead. Marcio cuts it back. Marcio shot, save Waltman. Rebound, follow, and surprises header. Just deflected away.
What a save that time by Danny Waltman on Marcio Liete.
Great save. Just got a little piece of it, deflected over the bar. Quiros thought about it. He will launch one in, and it's deflected by Stokic. Well, I'll tell you, the Comets again. Shot blocking tremendously. Now Phil Surprise. He'll crank up the left footer wide right. Rebound back out to Walls. Kiddos, he'll launch a three. Save made. Waltman had a good look at that one. Surprise gets it back. The rookie out of the Milwaukee area. Former star at Pius XI High School and then went on to have an excellent career at Quinnipiac University in Hamden, Connecticut. Oliviero, little touch back. Walls with a shot, and it's blocked by the rolling Stokic.
Great job by the Wave. Sustained pressure here in the Missouri end. Crowd sensing it. The Wave throwing the kitchen sink right now at Missouri.
All right, corner kick coming for the Wave. Marcio Liete on the ball. Liete, the Wave's leading playmaker with 21 assists coming in. Marcio been red hot the last couple games, but the Comets have done a good job to shut him down today.
Missouri with one restart goal here. The Wave needs one of their own.
Check out Everton moving in from the near side. Instead, they go over the top. LSO will crack a bouncing three. Deflected away by Harrison, now sent into the stands.
Yep, and top of the arc restart.
Boy, that one went above the scoreboard. That was quite a clearance there. But Milwaukee will get the restart. Let's see what they do here.
That's what that good defensive pressure will do, Tom. Forces the opponent into mistakes in their own end. Coach Tozer with two timeouts. He's going to take one right here.
So Keith Tozer trying to get this crowd fired up here. Big restart chance coming for the Wave. As they trail it by two with 11:59 left to go. Here in the third period, Wave Soccer is brought to you in part by the Freighter and the Medical College of Wisconsin Sports Medicine Center, by Ground Maintenance Services, Sobelman's Pub and Grill, the KinderCare Learning Centers, Milwaukee Kickers, Curtis Ambulance Service, Major Goolsby's, the official pre- and post-game party site of your Milwaukee Wave, and Palermo's Pizza. A couple other games going on in the MISL as we wrap up the 2013-14 season. And let's see, right now with Rochester at Syracuse and Baltimore at Pennsylvania. Blast that jumped out to an early first quarter lead in that one. I believe it was 8-0, either late first period, early second period. And last I saw, Rochester had a 3-2 lead over Syracuse. Anyway, we'll get you the further updates as they come along here. Well, what do you think here? It looked like they were going to do the double step over, but let's see what they
do. It still appears that that's what we're going to do. You'll probably see Oliveira run over it, Kiros run over it, and then Liete come up with a bombosa.
LSO takes the shot. And the defensive wall kept its ground for the Comets. Feenstra will send it back in. Kiddos, little header to the middle. Bennett trying to get through. Now LSO with a shot blocked in the middle. Comets cleared out. Fabinho over the back. He'll get called for the foul.
Got to be intelligent there. There's no reason to foul. You got Missouri pinned into their own zone. The onus is on them to work the ball out. Committing a foul there just allows them to gain possession.
Rodriguez shaking off the foul at 10. Now Feenstra up the middle for Liete. Touches it back to Victor Kiddos along the board. J.C. Banks trying to get through, but good job that time by Matingu, and J.C. Banks going to get called for the foul.
Once again, so important, Tom, you do not foul. Force Missouri to work the ball forward.
Andre Braithwaite with it. He'll play it back for Waltman. Sosa into the zone. Gibson, who's back in there now. Remember, he had taken the game's first penalty on a dissent call late in the third period. Comets control. They are in blue going right to left here in the fourth period. Kiddos with pressure gets it back for the goalkeeper. Eventually they work it upfield, but Braithwaite is there. Andre Braithwaite wasn't playing all that much at the beginning of the season, but it looks like he's moved into the defensive rotation here. Already, he's done a nice job so far.
Looks very good. Physically, reminds me a lot of Tijani Ayagbusi. Built very similarly.
Good. Yeah, good analogy there. Andre Braithwaite, originally from Kingston, Jamaica. He will turn 25 on May 15th. Oh, shot there. Save made. Rebound. Follow. And just off the mark. Sosa with it. Sosa lays it off near side. Now Matingu trying to get through. Fabinho able to check it off and clear, but Comets regain. Ferreira with pressure at midfield, but Asapour able to get it back for the goalkeeper, Waltman. Remember, Waltman not afraid to push the ball forward as a goalkeeper. Ooh, coming in and just missing that time. Gibson, it was close. Perez on the follow, blocked by Fabinho. Good job by Fabinho.
Kiros got a little too close to Gibson that time, and Leo was able to spin Victor and get a good shot on goal.
Now Perez trying to cut back. And the Comets doing a good job to keep the possession. Fast-moving contests. Not a lot of whistles really throughout the game. And just one penalty, as I said, that dissent call to Gibson back in the third period. That did not result in a power play, so we've had no power plays here thus far. Don't forget, Wave and Comets will meet in the semifinals in the MISL playoffs if this score holds. Game one Sunday in Missouri, 3 o'clock kickoff. Game two in Milwaukee, Monday, March 10th, 7 o'clock kickoff here at the Cell. Call the Wave office, 414-224-WAVE, to order your tickets. That's 414-224-9283. You can also order online at milwaukeewave.com, your source for everything Milwaukee Wave. Everton looking for some cutters. Everton picked up his sixth assist on that goal by Fontana earlier in the period to draw Milwaukee back with it too.
Missouri double teaming the Wave targets, Tom. I'd like to see the Wave targets spin away from that double team and try to attack the boards.
Gibson finds Rodriguez now looking to send Braithwaite's overlapping on the attack. Shot was high, rebound. Rodriguez shot and a goal. Oh, what a conversion there by Lucas Rodriguez. Huge three ball for the Comets, and they lead it 9-4. Big time conversion by Rodriguez.
We talk about Rodriguez has been a thorn in the Wave side all year. Watch this strike by Lucas Rodriguez. You see the giveaway that time by Fontana. And then a postage stamp right there beats Feenstra to the upper corner.
That is a big time goal right there to the upper 90. Lucas Rodriguez, his second of the game, 14th of the year. Let's send it down to Van McNeil.
Fox 6, wake up to fun. It's news and we're the first and it's local. Nicole Coughlin is here from Fox 6, wake up in Real Milwaukee. Nicole, what's up?
That was pretty good, Van. Very good. Hey, I'm up in section 324 with a great group today from the Kettle Moraine Soccer League. Hey, everybody! Let's take a look at the board to see the other groups and birthdays we're celebrating today.
Thanks, Nicole. Nicole Coughlin with us. How about a nice round of applause for Nicole on her day off here, hanging with your Milwaukee Wave. Check out Fox 6 Wake Up News and Real Milwaukee, weekdays at 9, only on Fox 6.
You see some of the birthdays and groups here on stage. They're trying to check the replay down below. The officials are. It's even a three-pointer. It sure looked like it from out here, and they did confirm. It was indeed a three-point goal by Lucas Rodriguez, his second of the game, 14th of the year, unassisted at 7:08, as Rodriguez bags his second three-pointer of the year, the 15th for the Comets. They've actually been a negative deficit three-point team. Scoring 15, giving up 21, so they're minus 6. Wave yields at 17th. They've scored 22, so they're still a plus 5.
Not sure what they were looking at. The shot was outside the yellow line.
Even back in the old days, yeah, when it was the yellow line the first few years, that would have been a three-pointer.
There's the recipe for the Wave, Tom. You got 7:50 left. Get a goal here before the five-minute mark to get it back to 9-6. Get it down to 9-8 with 3 minutes to go, and then take your chances on the sixth attacker. One goal every 2.5 minutes.
That is the formula right there. Fabinho chips in, the Oliveiro header, and Danny Waltman able to grab it for the Comets. Waltman once again playing a superlative game here at the U.S. Cellular Arena, just like he did last week in their 15-9 victory. Comets do not look uncomfortable at all playing the Wave here at the Cell, at least not the last two times. Wave did beat them here 16-4 the first time these teams met, but that was one day after the Comets had shellacked Milwaukee 22-4 down in Independence. Only other Wave victory this year over Missouri was that thrilling opening night's 23-21 overtime victory, in which Wave rallied from 6 points down in the last couple minutes of the game to tie it up. Out of play, Wave will take it. Comets has done a good job to take the crowd out of this one here today. This is a nice crowd here for the regular season finale at the U.S. Cellular Arena, but haven't had a lot to cheer about offensively. Not that it has not been an exciting game, with more opportunities for the Wave than belies the score. Greenfield looks in. Pereira turns. Pereira tried to jam one through against Danny Waltman. Couldn't do it. And Nick called for a foul as he got the leg way up on a dangerous play there.
Could save that time again by Waltman at the near post after Pereira had spun the defender. But once again, the Wave lets the Comets off the hook with a foul in their own zone. Greenfield's got the man trapped in.
Gibson drives one across the goal mouth. He'll come back to midfield, and Rodriguez has it. And the Comets working it around here. Ball sent back in. Banks and Gibson go to the corner. Comes off the shelf. Perez with a shot. That's wide. Greenfield with it. Pereira, now errant pass there. Leo Gibson with it. Tried a little behind the back pass that didn't work out. Banks, Pereira, looking across back for J.C. Banks. The rookie out of UWGB spinning, trying to control, but just couldn't keep the possession there as the teams are changing up. Clock down to 5 minutes to go here. Kiddos volleys to midfield. Perez is there.
Well, you got to be thinking about six attacker now, Tom.
Waltman chipping high to midfield. Over the head of Braithwaite. Boy, it's a good thing Braithwaite isn't a center fielder in baseball, that's for sure. Feinstra lays it up, but Braithwaite is there at midfield. And now gets it back, drives it in. Feinstra comes out. Fontana try to turn up the boards, but he gets cut off on the play. Ivanovic back for Waltman. I tell you, Comets have rarely been out of position the whole game today, either offensively or defensively. Judson McKinney takes it. Fontana, Marcello with a drive that's off. Rebound. LSL fires a shot. Save Waltman. Fontana gets it back. Marcello triple teamed, and the Comets come away with it. Gibson is dumped by McKinney. Foul is called. So it's looking more and more like it's going to be the Wave in the Comets for the fourth consecutive season. In the MISL semifinals, Wave winning the series in 2011 and 2012 when they went on to defeat Baltimore for the MISL title. Last year, the Comets were able to come away with the victory, and then they met Baltimore in the championship, only to lose to the Blast. Now LSO trying to do a little too much. Maybe it felt surprise flashing on the far side. Gibson cuts inside of Tony Walls. Foul is called.
Way very fortunate they didn't get a two-minute penalty called against them, both behind the play and then there with the foul right there.
3:13 to go, and
see the foul by Walls on Gibson. There's also a foul behind the play that referee Shane Butler allowed the play to continue.
Harris will take the shot. Thought maybe they might try to knock it back, but I guess it serves the same purpose because they can do it now. Well, I'll tell you one thing, Art. With Ossetpour back in the lineup, it gives you so much more confidence in this knock-it-around situation when you've got him out on the field. He returns the lineup after a four-game absence and thought he looked pretty good here today. Now back to Feinstra. Timeout called. Wave will go with the extra attacker, I believe, with 2:41 left to go.
Well, they had some success earlier in the season at Missouri against the Comets' sixth attacker defense. They're going to need a minor miracle here to pull this one out.
So, again, you guys know the situation. Unless the Wave stages a miracle rally here, it will be the Wave and the Missouri Comets in the first round of the playoffs. Game one would take place this Sunday, March 9th, 3 p.m. at the Independence Event Center in Independence, Missouri. Check out MissouriComets.com for ticket information there. And then quick turnaround right back here at the Cell a week from tomorrow, Monday, March 10th, 7 p.m. That would be game two of a best of three. And the third game would occur if the team split the first two. It's a 15-minute minigame with golden goal overtime.
Well, selfishly, Tom, we were hoping to be able to call that decisive championship game if the Wave were to get that far. But there's still a possibility. The Wave beats Missouri in the first round of the playoffs, and Syracuse somehow knocks out the Blast in the first round.
Blast, by the way, 8-0 at halftime, so the Roar has stabilized a bit defensively there.
You talk about if it is Baltimore and Syracuse in the semifinals, a very interesting matchup as the big cat, Michelle Millwood, would face off against his former team, the Baltimore Blast. And any team that has Millwood as one of their big strikers has always got a chance.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. Syracuse did pull out a victory against Baltimore this year and took them down to the wire one other game at the On Center. Victor Quito says, down the jersey. He will be the sixth attacker. 2:41 left to go in the Wave.
We're not done yet here, Tom.
Could really use a West Bend Silver Lining three-point goal right about now. That would definitely make things interesting.
Yep.
Far side, Bennett. He'll crank up a three. Save made, Waltman. Good strike by Ian, but a good save by Waltman, who has been right there. Again, has been out of position this whole game. Bennett again, stepping in. Passer shot is knocked out. Kiddos bangs it off the wall. Liete battles to get it along with LSO. As Matingu is also in there for the Comets. Tell you, Matingu, for being a recent signee, he's actually done okay today. Playing in a, you would have to say, a fairly high-pressure game.
It's been very good. Him and Braithwaite.
Yeah, a couple of young defenders stepping up big for the Comets here. Pereira, Bennett off the end board, flicked on by Oliviero, and LSO with a blast. Tight angle up into the stands. So we talked about with the injury to Cody Andrews, their big defender, veteran defender, how that might impact the Comets, but at least for now, they've got a couple of young guys in the back stepping up pretty well for them.
Well, the Wave's going to have a week to figure this out before they meet this same team in the semifinals and figure that man, Danny Waltman, out.
Yeah, absolutely.
You've said it all game long, Tom. He has been sensational. And really, it started last week against the Wave, continued into the St. Louis game where he ended up shutting out St. Louis before they made a goalkeeper change. And then again tonight, outstanding by Danny Waltman.
Just over a minute to go. And the Wave trying to see if they can get a couple of quick lightning strikes here. LSO, oh, great save, Waltman, rebound, follow, but Oliviero's header couldn't make it through.
Little exclamation point that time by Danny Waltman. Beautiful save going to his right-hand side.
Yeah, that was a great strike by LSO, no question about it.
Well, if there's any consolation, I do get a kick out of listening to Nick Vassos and Jim Schwab. So we'll have the opportunity to listen to those guys.
Absolutely, the Missouri broadcast team. Bennett with a crack just off the mark. Now Pereira, Oliviero, shot save, Waltman. And there is your number one star of the game, Danny Waltman. Outstanding effort today by he and the entire Comets defensive unit. 7 seconds left. Wave will get a free kick in its attacking zone. No, they say apparently deflected out. So they'll have to kick it in. Kudos for the long ball. And that'll be it. The Missouri Comets
come to Milwaukee again and beat the Wave for the second time in consecutive Sundays. The final score here, Missouri 9, Milwaukee 4. Wave finishes 16-4, all four losses coming to the Comets, and they finish 2-4 against in the season series. 1-2 both in Independence and Milwaukee. And the Comets finish 14-6, 7-3 on the road, 7-3 at home, 7-3 on the road. As Waltman coming up with the big saves as we kick off the Badger Max post-game show. Danny Waltman, the primary star of this game. Well, Art, final thoughts on today's game of the regular season?
Well, wraps up a good regular season, 16-4. 16-4, really can't be disappointed with that season. So, you know, here we go. Second season begins next week, next weekend.
Next week against the Missouri Comets. Book it, baby, as soon as the Comets came in this league. It's been the Wave and the Comets. So again, game one, Sunday, March 9th in Independence. That'll be a 3 o'clock kickoff time. And check MissouriComets.com for the ticket info. And then we will come back here for game two and possibly game three on Monday, March the 10th. That will be a 7 p.m. kickoff here at the U.S. Cellular Arena. Monday Night Football here at the U.S. Cellular Arena, the Waves' home playoff game, Monday, March 10th at 7 p.m. Check it out at MilwaukeeWave.com or call 414-224-WAVE to order your tickets. My thanks once again to Wave Hall of Famer Art Kramer and the entire U.S. Cellular Arena production crew. Tom Wynn wishing you a good one. And once again, our final score, the Missouri Comets 9, the Milwaukee Wave 4. Tom Wynn wishing you a good one. You've been watching the Milwaukee Wave and the Major Indoor Soccer League.
All right, Wave fans, here is the MISL playoff scenario. So with this loss today, your Milwaukee Wave will travel to Missouri Sunday, March 9th at 3 o'clock for game one of the MISL playoffs. Game two, the next night, a Sunday-Monday series, Sunday in Missouri, Monday night here for Monday Night Football, 7 o'clock. Tickets start at $7. You can purchase them before you leave at the U.S. Cellular Arena box office or, of course, online at MilwaukeeWave.com. So one more time, game one of the MISL playoffs, Sunday afternoon down in Missouri, 3 o'clock. Watch the game live on YouTube. And then Monday night, 7 o'clock, March 10th, here at U.S. Cellular Arena. Like I said, MilwaukeeWave.com has all of that information. On behalf of the entire crew here at U.S. Cellular Arena, under the direction of Mr. Charlie Wise, my name is Van McNeil. Final score, Milwaukee Wave 4, Missouri Comets 9. Good night, everyone. Post-game autograph session is next.